lift her out and if you spread them and put them on the side that they belong, it'd be good. Make sense?
Mm-hmm.
No, that ain't where it belongs, is it?
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah,
it's oh, you got second. I thought you started with the first.
No.
Yeah, if you can't get them, just go underneath and push. I'll let you do that.
As long as it works.
Be a good mid-range engine.
Do we even know what bell springs are on it?
I think, I don't know.
Do we know what Campbell's in it?
Almost stock.
Bell springs are probably going to be a little on the light side.
Can't the factory valve train handle up to about a 500 lift? Mm-hmm. Or is that just the rocket arms?
Well, I don't know, dude. I've had stock rockers on a lot bigger lift.
Do they have the dual springs on the factory?
It doesn't matter. It's the seat pressure.
Okay,
the open and closed seat pressure. So, my question to you is the same question I asked you before.
Yeah, how far are we going?
Yeah, what do you want to do with it? Because I can take them heads down on the machine guy and probably charge you a couple $100. It'll set the spring heights for the cam that's in there. Mm-hmm. It'll go through it, make sure they're good, boil them out, clean them up, and then check the valve jobs and stuff and the guides and seat with the seals and all that shit.
Might as well.
You know, I think that he charged Tyler like two, I think he charged him two bills to do a set of stock deck.
Yeah. I think that's reasonable. Plus, if we take this off, can he mill heads?
Well, he'll make sure they're straight.
Yeah, but I meant like, I don't know the piston, we'll be able to see how far down in the hole the piston
is. Yeah, I can measure how far it's, I mean, if it is, see where it's at. I'm sure, well, we don't know. You said that the guy rebuilt this thing, so I mean, it might have 10.5 one piston.
Yeah.
We'll know when the head comes on.
Mm-hmm. I tried to match my docks when I put that on there. But then I got the oil slinger, too.
Set it on the bolt side, the flat side. Put the head bolts on there, too.
Factory pistons, or do you think?
Oh, I don't know. When we flip it over, we can see that. We're going to have to take our wire wheel and clean the top one of the pistons off and see the size of their overboard.
Why don't you put the timing chain out there, pull that cam out of it?
Just curiosity, when you put that cam together, Loctite that's not?
This one? No.
All the pulls Loctite.
See, that's why I thought it'd be a good idea to.
Put it in your bucket over there. I don't know how you put them in or take them out, but three bolts in there.
We found the only part number on the cam, and we're going to try to figure out more specifically what it is. Otherwise, we'll take some measurements and give that to the machine shop so that they know what kind of valve springs to put on there to check the valve springs here and see if we were good enough. All right.
So anyways, so the machine shop wanted me to check it in the block. So you set it at zero.
Mm-hmm.
What I got in here is I got a solid lifter with this rod that's in it.
Yeah.
So that's what's riding on the cam load. So obviously there's no chain on here, so
yeah.
Watch it. So it's set on zero.
Mm-hmm.
It'll come around. Now it's starting to lift.
Mm-hmm.
So you count 1, 2, 3, about 336, 337. So what you do with that? So we'll just say it's 337. So okay. 3, 1.37 times 1.5, because that's your rocker ratio, equals, that's the lift of the cam.
Because he was getting different numbers, but he just had it set up in his lathe with one of these on it. Well, with the lifter in, it's a little different, so it took some off. He was coming up with 525.
Okay.
You know, off his lathe, and then he's like, nah, dude, just take it home and shove it in the block.
Yeah.
Because I got all this stuff for three in the cam, so. They're setting the heads up for a 510 lift.
Yeah. Okay. So, yeah. Unless you want
it. This is a perfect time to switch it.
Yeah.
No, I don't want nothing to do it because I don't know what it is.
Yeah. Yeah.
We got the
lift. I figured with this, we got all the stuff we need to get it set right.
Yeah. But, I mean, like I said, with this one, we're just, you know, yeah, we can figure out the lift. And, yes, you can figure out the duration and all that shit. But it's just a whole bunch of work that we don't have to do.
Yeah.
You know, the only bad part with the new camshaft is you're taking a chance that lifters aren't going to fucking
shit. Yeah.
Yeah.
I have to get some break-in oil.
Well, you're going to dyno it, you're going to find out on the dyno.
Yeah. Well, that's what I want to do.
If you dyno this thing, I mean, you'll know.
Yeah.
Normally they're advanced already. See?
Yeah.
Got a third thing. It's got bearing on the back. This is the exact chain I buy for all my motors. Hitting the zero right now, so that's the top of the load.
Yeah.
Okay, so you go past it. Now, if you watch the gate over here, you go past it. 25. So now it hits more. But then you go down here, the top dead center is there. So just, I mean, you know, 90 goes to there. So 90, you got 100, 110, 120, 130, 140. That's what we got the first time. And then come back to 25. Now we'll read it. Now you just go not 74. Well, we got the first time. So we're good. Lock her down, call it a day. The lifter spin. They got a slight taper on the camshaft that makes the camshaft go this way. So it always holds it back. Friday night and everyone.
So I sort of shot this video out of sequence. I bought this engine originally from Ryan Barsness for $600. It was a running 76440. They had put 906 heads on it. It had a cast iron four barrel intake on it. And the guy ran it in a 67 Charger with a four speed. Then I also had the extra cam from the Jack Pine. So I thought, well, it might liven the engine up a little bit if we put that in here. Because originally that was when Gary took it out, he said he thought it was like a 510 lift cam, which would have been kind of nice for this engine. It was more like 540 lift, and it was a solid lifter cam. So I traded with Ryan for a mystery cam. It was supposed to be kind of similar to the Mopar 509 purple shaft, but it's got no markings, so we couldn't get enough information on it. And I figured part of the reason I brought it here is because I was more confident having Mopar Jeff 604 help me sort this engine out, make sure that we give it the best chance possible for it to run good. I wound up buying a Lenati cam that was recommended by just Mopar Joe. We did take the heads in. Everything should be a little bit better than what I was originally planning to do with this engine. And we'll show you more when we buy it.